How to create AWS Aurora database, add reader node for high availability, perform failover to different AZ. We'll see this and much more, so please stay put. If you like what you see today, do subscribe. Together we'll learn more. Now fun part. Learn Aurora database failover by doing. Let's get started. Important disclaimer, Aurora database is not part of the free tier, so if you intend to be in free tier, just please watch me doing. We logged into AWS Management Console. Go to All Services and you can find RDS under Databases. Just scroll down and you can find RDS. Click there. Here we can create database. So just click on Databases on left panel. Right, nothing is running, so we'll start our first database. So Amazon Aurora is pre-selected, we'll keep it as is, and capacity type is provisioned, not serverless, just pay attention to it. Right, so template, instead of production, choose dev test, so we do not end up paying more, right? And here click on auto generate password. We're not going to use the password, so don't worry about that. And here to choose burstable class, which is a cheapest option for tutorial purpose. So rest, I'm just keeping it as is. If you notice, I didn't create read replica, which can be created as part of database creation itself. But intentionally, I didn't create it. And we are just skimming through our options here, what are the configurations available, but basically we can keep default and just create database. Yeah, so database is being created. You can see status, which is creating, and note down region, US East 1. So we'll just pause the video and come back and discuss more on next steps, because it takes time for instance to create. Okay, so instance is available now, and you can see that it is in US 1A, that is a AZ, and role is writer. So let's add reader node, and we'll intentionally add it to different AZ now, right? Because the current writer is in AZ 1A, now we'll add it in 1B and just give some database instance identifier Aurora reader, keep burstable class, and here give preference as 1B. So everything else keep it as is and add reader. So status for reader is it's creating. So, and you can see AZ is 1B. So writer is in 1A and reader is in 1B. So, and it's available now. So once you see that reader is available, you can just go to modify, right, and just go down, and here you can give first preference for the failover priority. So I'm making it tier 0 and continue. Everything else we didn't touch, only we changed failover priority to tier 0, apply immediately, right? So just refresh once and you can see that it is applied. So now we'll go and do failover. So these are in different AZ, right? So that is the purpose of failover. So we are just failing over to reader. So let's see how it works. So just click on failover. And once you click there, right, just refresh it once. Take some time, but just wait for a few minutes and you can see that failing over is a status. So whatever we are doing is like it's on track, so it's just failing over. So just wait and we should be able to see that writer should be in US East 1B. Yeah, and that precisely it. It takes time to fail over, but you can see that like it is done now. So writer is in 1B and reader is in 1A, And that's how failover happens in Aurora. So it's very easy to do it from portal, and same thing you should definitely do it from command line. But yeah, this is easy to understand how things work, and that is how we can just use failover option. Make sure you clean up the lab. That is very important. So just put delete me and click on delete. So that's how we are deleting one reader instance. So now do the similar thing for writer as well. So just go to action, delete, and I don't want to create final snapshot. I acknowledge that I'm not creating snapshot, and then just delete me and click on delete. So your reader instance is also being deleted. So both instances are being deleted, and slowly you will see that even our cluster will show that it is deleting. Let me pause and come back. So quick recap, we learned how to create Amazon Aurora cluster. We added reader node, and once that is done, we change failover priority and we did failover so that reader becomes writer and writer becomes reader. So these things we have learned today, and I hope like this was valuable and you learned something new. Thanks for watching. We learned a lot of things, and most importantly, we learned it by doing. Thanks for watching. Please do share this video with others so that we can help them learn as well. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel so that you do not miss next videos I am coming up with.